Tonight, we're investigating the condition of Seattle's iconic Ballard Lock. The locks are a major tourist attraction.
And they're also critical to everything that floats in Lake Union and Lake Washington, including two freeway bridges. And tonight, KIRO 7's Graham Johnson shows you the critical pieces that need to be replaced.
1.3 million people visit the Ballard Locks each year. Few see this, a room that looks like a museum.
These are actually 1909. Motors, both of them.
They still run, but the pipes that connect to them are crumbling.
It's time to replace that pipe.
Nate McGowan is the operations project manager at the Hiram M. Chittenden Locks, which the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers opened in 1917. The two locks connect Puget Sound with the higher water level in Lakes Union and Washington, moving 49,000 vessels through the ship canal each year.
We'll head all the way down to the pump floor.
McGowan took us deep into a pumping plant. Long past its prime.
You can see this pipe was built in 1915, 100 years ago. And here, 50 feet below the lake level, there is a lot of corrosion. Some of this metal simply flakes right off.
That's the outside of it. The inside of it, of course, is much worse.
Until a pipe burst, these pumps emptied the large lock for annual maintenance. For the last 3 years, the Corps of Engineers has been improvising with much smaller portable pumps.
It's pretty slow. This
pump out is so slow, the every November closure to marine traffic that once lasted 14 days now takes 21. Shipbuilders, machinery makers, and construction companies are all affected.
Lots of money, lots of jobs, lots of commerce relies on this place.
The locks are not just a connection, but a dam for regulating the lake level. To see what's at stake, we got on a boat with Rick Rada of the Washington State Department of Transportation.
This is our I-90 work boat.
The I-90 and 520 floating bridges are together used by more than 200,000 drivers each day. We asked Rada about the worst case scenario, a failure at the locks that could trigger a rush of water toward Puget Sound.
Lake Union's going to be a mess. The houseboats, the fishing boats, everything that's tied on the shoreline.
Rada took us into a pontoon on I-90 to show where workers would adjust anchor cables if Lake Washington began dropping.
If we have a large loss of pool, we're going to be taking this cable up a long ways.
Rada says the bridges would survive, but traffic on I-90 might be slowed to as little as 25 miles per hour because a bump would form between the fixed and floating portions of the bridge. While it's never happened in 98 years, a breach of the Ballard Locks could come from a major earthquake or a big hit from a barge. The Army Corps of Engineers would stop the lake from draining by stacking these bulkheads in the water just above the locks. But that emergency plan depends on this crane, which dates back to 1922.
Any crane operator off the street would be surprised to see this in operation.
The levers and dials are antiquated. After a cable problem was discovered and fixed in 2013, the Corps decided to no longer test the crane each year. Still, Nate McGowan says it will work in an emergency.
It's currently operational. It's just at the end of its life.
McGowan estimates a new crane would cost between $7 million and $9 million. In all, he says the locks could use $40 million in upgrades. So far, the federal government has allocated $3.5 million to remove the old pipes in the pumping plant, but no money to replace them.
It's very challenging keeping this aging infrastructure going.
McGowan says the saving grace for the Ballard Locks is that a century ago, the workers who built it overbuilt it. That solid construction is now buying time for an old Seattle landmark still playing a critical role. In Ballard, Graham Johnson, KIRO 7 News.
A few years ago, the Army Corps of Engineers downgraded the safety rating of the Ballard Locks to urgent. That is a move that may improve chances for funding.